Hello, this is Matthias Möhl for MamoWorld.com and welcome to the fourth class of our After Effects Expressions course. Today we want to take our car example from the first class to the next level, such that when we move the car, the wheels should rotate fully automatically to match this movement. Let's first do it the easy way with eye expressions, and then I also show you the more complex solution of doing it manually. So with eye expressions, we go to the library and search for wheel. We want to use a rotating wheel linear motion expression. The rotating wheel curvaceous motion works exactly the same way, but computes slower because it can also deal with curved motion path and wheels that change their size over time. So if you don't need those additional features, better use the faster rotating wheel linear motion. Now we enter as diameter the diameter of the wheel, which is 106 pixels in our case. Then we select both wheel layers and apply the eye expression. Now we keyframe a motion path for the car, and you can see that the wheels rotate as needed. Note that the wheels are parented to the car, so they move with the car due to the parenting and rotate due to the eye expression. Now let's try to create the same by writing our own expressions code. The key thing to understand is that when a wheel does a full rotation, the distance it travels is exactly the circumference of the wheel. So if the wheel has a circumference of 100 pixels, for example, and the car moves 300 pixels, then this is 3 times the circumference, and hence the wheel needs to do 3 full rotations. In other words, the number of rotations is the total distance that the car moved divided by the circumference. So what is the total distance that the car moved? To keep it simple, let's say our car moves only in x direction and starts at x equals 0. Then the distance traveled is exactly the x position of the car. So we start our expression on the rotation property by pick whipping to the x position to get the distance traveled. Then we need to divide this distance by the circumference to get the total number of rotations needed. How do we compute the circumference? If you look it up on Wikipedia, you will find that the circumference of a circle is simply pi times its diameter. So in parentheses, we enter 3.1415, which is approximately pi, and then times width. We can simply use width here, since the expression is on the wheel layer, and the width of the wheel layer is exactly the diameter of the wheel. So now our expression calculates total distance divided by circumference, which is the total number of rotations. But the rotation value is not given in total number of rotations, but in degrees. So if we have 1.5 total number of rotations, for example, the rotation should not be 1.5, but 1.5 times 360, because each full rotation has 360 degrees. So we add 360 times at the beginning of the expression. As you can see, the expression works as expected. But I guess you agree that this expression looks really complex and it's very hard to figure out how it is working. So in the next step, we want to make it more easy to understand by creating some variables. In the last class, you learned that After Effects provides you a lot of predefined variables to access things in your project. But you can also create your own custom variables. This works by writing var followed by a name that you invent, then equals, and then you write an expression that describes the value of this variable, and finally put a semicolon at the end. Let's say you have the very basic expression wiggle to 100. Then, instead of using 2 and 100 directly, you could create two variables for them. So you write var frequency equals 2, semicolon, which creates a variable with name frequency and the value 2. And in the same way, we create a variable amplitude with the value 100. Now, inside the actual wiggle, we don't use the hard-coded values 2 and 100 anymore, but use our variables instead. If you want to change the frequency later, in the new expression, it is much easier to see what the frequency actually is. In particular, if you want to link frequency or amplitude to a slider with a pick whip, the expression will stay way more readable due to the variables we introduced. So now let's do the same with our rotating wheel expression. The 360 times something in our expression was because we calculated the total number of rotations, and hence the actual rotation value is 360 times the number of full rotations. So we can say the main part of our expression is 360 times numRotations, where numRotations is a variable we have to define now. So above, we insert var numRotation equals in a semicolon, And now the question is, what is the value for num rotations? Well, it's exactly everything we have here in our expression. Transform position 0 divided by width times pi. Now we can simplify this even further. The idea for calculating the number of rotations was that it was the total distance divided by the circumference. So this part is the total distance and this part is the circumference. So let's isolate those parts in their own variables too. So we say var total distance equal and then copy this part and add a semicolon. And then we say var circumference equals and copy this part which computes the circumference. And again, end the line with a semicolon. Now the calculation of num rotations can use those new variables and can be simplified. Since this part is exactly the value of total distance, we can replace it by total distance. And this part is the circumference, so we can also just replace it by this variable. Finally, and this is probably a matter of taste, I want to add a new variable diameter, since the circumference is pi times the diameter, and I don't really find it obvious that the width in this formula actually means the diameter of the wheel. So we say var diameter equals width, semicolon. And now in the calculation of the circumference, we can say pi times diameter. Now the expression is much longer than the original one, but hopefully much better to understand. If we read it bottom up, we can see that the rotation needed is 360 degrees times the number of rotations. The number of rotations is calculated as a total distance that the car traveled divided by the circumference. And the details, how the total distance and the circumference are calculated, are found in those two lines. So one complex formula has been divided into several simpler steps with meaningful names. If we now want to adjust the expression later, such that it can deal with movements in y direction, for example, we know that we need to adjust how to calculate the total distance, because now also movements in y direction should be considered. So we would need to touch this part of the expression and everything else could stay the same. I hope this gives you an idea how useful it is to work with variables to write expressions code that is easy to understand and easy to modify. Finally, let's take a look at the limitations of the expression that we just developed. The first, more severe limitation is that it does not work if the wheel is parented, as in our car rig from the beginning. Parenting is not possible because our expression measures the distance traveled by looking at the keyframed x position of the wheel layer itself, and it ignores movement caused by as a parent. Support for parented layers can be added with so-called layer space transforms, but this is a pretty advanced topic that we will cover in a later class of this course. Another limitation is that since we only look at the x position to measure the distance, only horizontal movements are supported. Also, of course, we assumed that the diameter of the wheel does not change over time. If you need any of those advanced features, please use the rotating wheel of the iExpressions physics bundle, as they have none of those limitations. That's the end of this part of our series. In the next part, we cover how to write expressions for 2D and 3D values. As always, if you can't wait to see the next part, please subscribe to our newsletter. Again, this is Matthias Möhl for MamoWorld.com. See you next time.